One of the things I haven't talked about is how much how you print has to do with the design. Now, if I was to take this one leaf right here, I could print this one leaf like that. Look at how interesting that is. I could print that one leaf by scrunching and maybe just printing part of it. I could also print that one leaf just by lightly dragging a little bit of the sponge across the leaf. So I get a slight drag mark in the design as I'm printing because I'm dragging the stencil. So you can see how much more interesting the printing is when you play with how you print. So you want to print with a firm hand, with a nice even hand, and work with different colors at the same time, because that's really what's going to make your stenciling more interesting. If you have a design where you want to reverse the image and flip the image, you can do that really easily with a stencil. So this is a stencil called Wings, and you can see they're half of wing shapes, mostly halves. And so if I was to print, say, half of this shape, print the whole shape and then flip it over for the other half, I could get a butterfly shape to happen. So what I would want to do is print it once. Wow, it's beautiful on that dark fabric, isn't it? So after I do the first print, I'm just going to take and lightly, with a clean sponge, wipe off any excess paint. I can also blot it with a paper towel. There's not that much paint there, so it's not going to come off, but I want to make sure that when I lay this down the second time and I flip it over, it's not going to get paint on my fabric. You can see now when I flip it over, I can see the other image through there, so it helps me to line this up. So I can totally make a really beautiful symmetrical image out of this one stencil design. So any of the images would work that way. Even if it doesn't suggest that to you, like a wing maybe suggests you should have two, one on each side, but any image can do that. You know, a leaf, a flower, any image that you have that you like could work that way. So let's print something that isn't an obvious flip over half looking design to start with, and let's just print it in a couple of different ways. So here's a leaf shape, and if I print one of them and I pick that up, I have to tell you, one of the things I do if I feel like there's too much paint is I use the heel of my hand and I go like that and I lift up. If there's like an extra little blob somewhere, I'll pick it up on that heel of my hand, and it works really well. So now I'm going to wipe this off and flip it over, and let's see what we get if we just print it kind of slightly overlapping. So that makes a really pretty shape. The shapes can also kind of roll into each other. So here's a really great shape. Some things that aren't borders can make borders. Like here's a really beautiful shape right here. And I can take this and I can make this weave itself back together and create a movement design out of just that one shape. So you can see how that's, you know, one is kind of folding into the other. And I could even continue it overlapping this way, which is kind of interesting. See, it's great that the stencils are slightly see-through. It's a mylar that's see-through so that you can actually see what's happening with your design. So the design can work that way, and it could also cross and continue to make a shape and slightly turn and go off in another direction. I always play on scraps of fabric or extra pieces rather than my finished project, because the surprises are how the stencil will move. I might want a border design, but realize when I link these together, they make a curve, which I hadn't expected. And I may want to use that in my design. So I always want to play somewhere so I can see what will the design do, what are the possibilities, so that as I get to my finished piece, I have more options. I'm also feeling like this one would be really lovely to add a little spark to of another shape that maybe plays and kind of comes in and out of what I already have there. So this is when I might use a second color or, you know, flip a little piece over and go back and forth with another image. I want to show you how to print this really beautiful multi-tone effect with your stencil, where you're basically laying one stencil down and printing multiple colors at the same time. So this is a great example of that particular technique. I'm going to be printing on this silk organza, and because it's so sheer, whenever you print on something really sheer, you need another layer of fabric or a paper towel underneath it, because the paint basically goes through and stains that top layer, and if it's plastic, it will just make a bad print. So I want something to absorb the paint on the other side. So I'm going to take this nice little border here, and I'm going to do it with several colors. And I'm not really going for the colors to mix, but I'm just going to print along one edge of the stencil with each color. So I'm printing one edge, and I think I'm going to take a second sponge, and then I'm going to print the other edge with a totally different color. Now I can leave the center kind of unblended or unmixed, and you can see on this textured fabric it leaves kind of a bumpy texture to the edge of the printing. And I can also drop that back and go back and pick up a third color in the middle, which I'm going to pick up sort of this metallic and see what happens down the center of this if I start to let those colors blend each other. And you can see the multicolor look where you print through several colors at one time on one stencil gives a really great effect. Let's take a minute and clean this stencil off. You want to do this pretty much right after your session so that the stencil stays crisp and you don't lose the design because the paint fills in the holes. So what I do is I take a little bit of, I like the organic cleaners, the green cleaners or the orange cleaners. You can also use any kind of antibacterial kitchen cleaner. If this paint has sat on the stencil for a long time, you could use acetone, like a fingernail polish remover, to get that hard stuff off. So what I have in the pan is a little bit of water and some of the detergent type cleaner. And I'm going to take my stencil, I'm just going to lay it down there to soak for a few minutes. Since I'm doing this right after the printing session, I'm just going to let it sit for 10 or 15 minutes and then I'll be ready to clean it off. So it's been sitting for a few minutes and I'm going to take it out of the water. And I'm just going to lay it on the paper towel. And what I'm using is, I'm using a kitchen sponge that has that Teflon kind of a soft scrubber surface on it. And I like that for cleaning the stencils off. So I want to put a little bit of water on the sponge. And I've got the paint side up on this piece of paper towel here. And all I'm going to do is lightly rub. And you want to kind of notice the direction of the design so that you're not lifting up any fragile parts. But as I do this, I'm just going to be lightly scrubbing the surfaces of the stencil, and you can see it comes off real easily. It actually makes a second stencil out of that paper towel if you've got any good ideas. So I'm just going to move that around on the paper towel a little bit and use that scrubber, and if I've used both sides, I might need to flip it over. You can see that kitchen scrubber works really well, and you can lightly go back and forth if the design allows. But that's taken all the paint off the surface. You're going to find that there might be a little bit of staining left on the surface, but for the most part, this will take off the bulk of the paint. Once the stencil is clean, I like to dry it off between a couple paper towels. So I'll put it down, I'll put a second one on top, and then I'll rub it to make sure that I've got all the moisture out of the stencil. I keep a file, and what I do is I have manila folders. So I like to put the stencils in between a couple of pieces of paper to keep them from hooking up on one another. Okay, let's heat set our project. The paint that you're using will have heat setting guidelines on the packaging. The average length of time that you need to spend heat setting with an iron is 30 seconds. Maybe a minute, depending upon the fabric type. But the important part is that the fabric painted surface needs to be completely dry before you start. So here I have a piece that I printed a little while ago and it's dry, so I'm ready to do the heat setting now. You want to use the iron as warm as the fabric can take the iron over the printed surface. Now if I had more paint on this, I would want to use a pressing cloth first so that the paint wouldn't be sticking to my iron. And you want to keep the iron moving over the printed surface for that 30 seconds minimum. And that's what heat setting is about. Now your fabric is ready to wash or make into your project. We've just covered a lot of the basic techniques for stenciling. I know you're going to come up with so many great ideas and designs of your own. Thanks for joining me in my studio.